If you will ask me about relationship between two people, it can be any. But in this video, I'm taking example of marriage. The relationship between husband and wife, relationship of you and your parents, relationship of your you and your children, you and your sibling. My prime principle is the displacement of Lagna Lord and the concerned house lord. Lagna Lord and third lord connection for relationship with siblings, Lagna Lord and fifth lord connection for relationship with children, Lagna Lord and fourth lord connection for relationship with mother, Lagna Lord and ninth lord connection for relationship with father, and Lagna Lord and seventh lord connection for relationship with life partner. So keeping in focus about life partner, I am talking that if the Lagna Lord and the seventh lord is 212 to each other, you should remember that this is Lagna Lord to seventh lord, not seventh lord to Lagna Lord. Right? I am making a set of houses. The result are almost the same with a little bit of ups and downs. A right? Little bit of modification that you will have to do as per house configuration. So seventh lord in 212 to Lagna Lord generally indicates an ignorance based relationship where you, the person having this particular combination, Lagna Lord and the seventh lord in 212 to Lagna Lord, it can be placed anywhere. I am talking of Lagna Lord, not of Lagna. Okay. Ascendant Lord. So when the seventh lord is 212 from the ascendant lord, what is happening? You are completely dedicated, devoted to your spouse, but your spouse is not completely dedicated, devoted to you. You have given your complete life, 100% time to them, but they are only coming to you when they are in need. They are only coming to you when they are free. For them, it is a relationship of convenience. Your dedication, devotion is utmost, but dedication, devotion from their part is failing. Though they listen to you and it is only your advices which works for them, but they will never acknowledge it. And most importantly, generally in such relationships, what happen? There is a gap between conversation. There is a gap in understanding. You are saying something in some other sense, they understand it in some other sense, which generally gives rise to fights over small matters. And there is also a difference between fundamental understanding. Right? If you are giving more importance to saving finances and traveling, enjoying vacations once a year, they are more prone to doing it every month. So a difference between thought, a problem in what you want to convey and what they understand. Complete dedication, devotion from your side, but from their side, this being a relationship of convenience only, they only come to you when they want something, is the setup. It becomes problematic. Generally, in such relationships, marriages are difficult to sustain. When you are analyzing about relationship, this is the most crucial factor that you have to keep in mind. Even seventh lord in 6, 8, 12 house will not be bad if they are well placed from Lagna Lord. They will be bad, but not that bad. Whereas Lagna Lord in Kendra, Kona, 1, 4, 7, 10, 5, 9 houses can also behave very badly, can give bad result in marriage if they are not well placed from Lagna Lord. Lagna being you, is prime focus, right? And if the spouse is ignoring you, then in that particular scenario, how can the relationship sustain? Another point is 311, Lagna Lord and seventh lord being 311 to each other. So you count from Lagna Lord to seventh. 311 is generally a good setup. But in this 311, what happens in starting? The relationship is difficult. More effort is needed. In this type of setup, what I have generally seen, one is the think tank, another is the workforce. But they take time to understand it. In reality, the workforce is pressurized to become a think tank, the think tank is pressurized to become a workforce. So, in starting, it needs a lot of working. Starting one and a half year, 2 year of marriage is not very good. There is a problem in understanding. But here, both the people are devoted to each other. Because of this devotion and dedication, things will start working. The person having this particular combination is very understanding and compromising also. So initially, there will be issues. They will try to be adamant. The one having this combination will try to be adamant, will try to force things over the spouse. But once they understand that somehow spouse cannot do it or is not comfortable doing that, they will mold their ways also. This is one of the best relationships where love, friendship, care for each other is completely intermingled in a proper balance, which makes a perfect relationship of which everyone is jealous of. But you have to work together, give proper time to understand each other, and there have to be compromise. There have to be your sacrifice for the happiness of other. Only in that scenario it works. Otherwise, if this is not done, then in that particular scenario, I have seen that marriage, the bliss of marriage is somehow lost in day-to-day duties, and in that particular scenario, it is just a relationship where both the couples are very busy and are not having time for each other, but somehow clinging to the relationship. When the Lagna Lord and Seventh Lord are 4-10 from each other, this is one of the best setup out of all these 12 setups. It is the best setup. The spouse is according to your choice. Spouse have all the qualities that you ever wanted. And these couple are very happy to sacrifice for each other, do anything for each other. They wholeheartedly love each other and their life is like dedicated and devoted to each other. In this particular scenario, generally the problems in profession or problems of settlement with family members becomes an issue. But other than that, everything else is very good. In this type of relationships, cheating, etc. seldom happens. If Lagna Lord or the Seventh Lord is afflicted, then cheating is a very common norm in such a relationship. But when it is a good setup, cheating will never happen. But profession and family can be an issue. But if the couple after marriage starts living separately, put their complete faith and trust on each other, then no one can stop this relationship from being successful. Next is Lagna Lord and Seventh Lord and 5-9 setup. In this particular scenario, you should understand 5 is child, 9 is father. So first of all, in starting, there is a struggle for authority. You know, everyone in the couple wants to be heard. Everyone in the both in the couple want that, you know, another person should listen to me. Right. But this is somehow a little bit difficult to come. So in this relationship, what happens? The relationship is good. More than loving, they are guiding each other. And the couple is dedicated and devoted towards each other's progress. This is a type of relationship where the spouse should progress. They should have a better life is the prime soul motive. In this relationship, there is a level of strictness also. Right. In this type of relationship, you are very much intolerant of whatever mistakes the spouse may make. And most importantly, in this type of relationship, in starting, I have seen people saying like, I don't know where I got struck into this relationship, what to do of it, right? So when afflicted, this becomes a problem where people cannot escape, can neither fully enjoy the relationship. But when these planets are not afflicted, when the relationship is very good, Lagna Lord is also affliction free, Seventh Lord is also affliction free, and they are into 5-9 relationship, then it is a very fortunate relationship. Year after childbirth, relationship becomes even more strong. And if the spouse, if the couple, if both of the couple or any one of them is creatively involved in any profession such as writing, teaching, content creation, etc., then the relationship is even more better, even good. More importantly, though there is a disciplinarian tendency, though there is clash of egos, etc., between the couple, but still in the end, both progress together. And between this enjoyment, they don't get time to focus on each other's blemishes. So this makes a good setup. When the Lagna Lord and Seventh Lord is 6-8 to each other, this is a very problematic scenario. Lagna Lord and Seventh Lord being in 6-8 to each other, because of some reason or the other, the enjoyment of marital life is not there. Either the spouse is very ill or very much into their work, or the family member of spouse wants them very often that you cannot enjoy with them, some or other type of problem always keeps on happening. There is no time when there is no mental, physical, social, emotional tension so that the couple can enjoy with each other. Generally, health issues, etc. comes to pass. In such relationships, having a child is generally problematic. There have to be medical aid for the birth of child. And if the child birth is normal, then in that particular scenario, while the child is growing up, it is a matter of tension. Right? So it is basically a difficult child which needs more care. Lagna Lord and Seventh Lord in a 6-8 setup is generally not a very good setup for relationship also. Understanding related issues are there between the couple. And because of these particular issues, both of the couple agreeing onto the same thing, wanting to do the same thing at same point of time is quite difficult. What one thinks is very important, another person thinks is very unnecessary. And because of this particular reason, they are never on the same track. And because they are not on the same track, their enjoyment of marriage is compromised. When the Lagna Lord and the Seventh Lord is together, when the Lagna Lord or the Seventh Lord is 1-7 to each other. Lagna Lord and Seventh Lord together is a very good setup initially. But you should understand a point that Lagna Lord and Seventh Lord are always inimical. So in that particular scenario where the Lagna Lord and Seventh Lord are conjoined with each other, both are getting afflicted. In such a relationship, person compromises a lot. But even after all these compromises, it seems like the relationship will not work out. This person is compromising a lot for relationship, but the demands of the spouse is never ending. And because of this particular relationship, it goes back to such a great extent that the couple does not want to see each other's face also. But in this particular scenario, if this is the case that Seventh Lord is exalted, Lagna Lord is Vargottam kind of a scenario where both the planets are getting power, then it is a soulmate kind of a connection where the couple understands each other very well. They are only focused towards happiness of each other only. And this is the type of relationship where the inner desire of the wife is expressed by the husband and the inner desire of the husband is expressed by the wife. They understand each other very much, enjoy things together. More than being a couple, they are friends, and it is a very, very good setup. If both of the planets are in a healthy condition, which is seldom the case. Because both of them will be inimical, generally the case is a relationship which was not good in starting, and slowly, slowly it converted into a relationship where the couple cannot sit together even for 2 hours straight. Right? Even when together, they do not gel up well, and there is always a difference of opinion between the two. Lagna Lord and Seventh Lord in 1-7 to each other is a relationship which is very good in initial phase. Honeymoon period, what we say. Is very good in the initial phase since they are starting till the time they have challenges to cope up with. They go very well. They work like a team. In traveling together, having fun together, enjoying things together, they are very good. But the time they sit together alone, the time they start spending time with each other, the differences of opinion with each other is very strong. That they become inimical towards each other. There is a competition between the couple. Generally, in such scenario, husband and wife are jealous of each other's progress, jealous of each other's blessings, and try to compete. And because of this particular competition, the happiness that they get from the relationship is highly compromised. Not only this, in this particular scenario, there are health issues as well. One partner is having health issues because of being very fat, etc., whereas another spouse is having problems such as dizziness, fainting, etc. Right? So they don't go well with each other. Even the choices of them are extremely different. Right? One likes hot food, one likes cold food kind of a scenario, and differences are so great that they cannot enjoy things together of day-to-day life. In doing adventure, tackling with problems, etc., they are good as a team. But enjoying things together, the small nuances of family life is difficult. And most importantly, in this particular scenario, one partner is very much attached to their home. Whereas another is very traveling kind of a person. And because of circumstances around their life, because of job commitments and other things, they seldom get time to understand each other. And when one will want to rest, another will have very important work kind of a setup it is. Once again, a competitive setup, where because of the intention of competing with each other, the couple cannot enjoy. This is the basic setup for all different setups of, this is the basic result for all different setups of Lagna Lord and Seventh Lord, which as I have told before, can also be applied with respect to Lagna Lord and Fourth Lord, Lagna Lord and Ninth Lord, Lagna Lord and Third Lord, Lagna Lord and Fifth Lord, for relationships with mother, father, siblings and children respectively. In case of any confusion, this should be your deciding factor regarding how the relationship should be. And I have not explicitly stated this is bad or this is good, because I don't believe in this particular concept. Every relationship has some good points and some bad points. Right? But I think you have clearly understood in which combination the relationship is supposed to sustain and in which combination the relationship is not supposed to sustain. So this should be kept in mind while doing analysis of marriage. Right?